You're listening to the audio production of Jesus Calling by Sarah Young, published by Thomas Nelson and read by Nan Gurley and Bill Russell.
January 1st. Come to me with a teachable spirit, eager to be changed. A close walk with me is a life of continual newness. Do not cling to old ways as you step into a new year. Instead, seek my face with an open mind, knowing that your journey with me involves being transformed by the renewing of your mind. As you focus your thoughts on me, be aware that I am fully attentive to you. I see you with a steady eye because my attention span is infinite. I know and understand you completely. My thoughts embrace you in everlasting love. I also know the plans I have for you, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Give yourself fully to this adventure of increasing attentiveness to my presence.
Reflect on the following words from Scripture about God's plan for your life.
Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11.
Think about the areas of your life where you may be clinging to old ways. Ask God for specific ways you can seek His presence to guide you as you step into a new year.
January 2nd. Relax in my healing presence. As you spend time with me, your thoughts tend to jump ahead to today's plans and problems. Bring your mind back to me for refreshment and renewal. Let the light of my presence soak into you as you focus your thoughts on me. Thus, I equip you to face whatever the day brings. This sacrifice of time pleases me and strengthens you. Do not skimp on our time together. Resist the clamor of tasks waiting to be done. You have chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from you.
Contemplate the following scriptures about finding strength in God's presence.
Look to the Lord and His strength. Seek His face always. Psalm 105, verse 4. She had a sister called Mary, who sat at the Lord's feet, listening to what He said. But Martha was distracted by all the preparations that had to be made. She came to Him and asked, "Lord, don't you care that my sister has left me to do the work by myself? Tell her to help me." "Martha, Martha," the Lord answered, "you are worried and upset about many things, but only one thing is needed. Mary has chosen what is better, and it will not be taken away from her." Luke chapter 10, verses 39 through 42.
As you ruminate on today's message about finding strength in God's presence, create a list of challenges you are facing this week. After every item in this list, ask God to give you His strength and healing to help you tackle each challenge.
January 3rd. Refresh yourself in the peace of my presence. This peace can be your portion at all times and in all circumstances. Learn to hide in the secret of my presence. Even as you carry out your duties in the world, I am both with you and within you. I go before you to open up the way, and I also walk alongside you. There could never be another companion as devoted as I am. Because I am your constant companion, there should be a lightness to your step that is observable to others. Do not be weighed down with problems and unresolved issues, for I am your burden bearer. In the world, you have trials and distress, but don't let them get you down. I have conquered the world and deprived it of power to harm you. In me, you may have confident peace.
Contemplate these verses about receiving God's peace.
Oh, how great is your goodness, which you have laid up for those who fear you, which you have prepared for those who trust in you in the presence of the sons of men. You shall hide them in the secret place of your presence from the plots of man. You shall keep them secretly in a pavilion from the strife of tongues. Psalm chapter 31, verses 19 through 20. I have told you these things so that in me you may have perfect peace and confidence. In the world you have tribulation and trials and distress and frustration. But be of good cheer, take courage, be confident, certain, undaunted. For I have overcome the world. I have deprived it of power to harm you, and have conquered it for you. John chapter 16, verse 33.
Take a moment to recognize how God is walking with you as you face challenging circumstances. Thank Him for the gift of His perfect peace in your life.
January 4th. I want you to learn a new habit. Try saying, "I trust you, Jesus," in response to whatever happens to you. If there is time, think about who I am in all my power and glory. Ponder also the depth and breadth of my love for you. This simple practice will help you see me in every situation, acknowledging my sovereign control over the universe. When you view events from this perspective, through the light of my universal presence, fear loses its grip on you. Adverse circumstances become growth opportunities when you affirm your trust in me, no matter what. You receive blessings gratefully, realizing they flow directly from my hand of grace. Your continual assertion of trusting me will strengthen our relationship and keep you close to me.
Reflect on the following words from Scripture about God's power.
I have seen you in the sanctuary and beheld your power and your glory. Psalm chapter 63, verse 2. See, the sovereign Lord comes with power, and His arm rules for Him. See, His reward is with Him, and His recompense accompanies Him. He tends His flock like a shepherd. He gathers the lambs in His arms and carries them close to His heart. He gently leads those that have young. Isaiah chapter 40, verses 10 through 11. Where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I go up to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle on the far side of the sea, even there your hand will guide me. Your right hand will hold me fast. Psalm chapter 139, verses 7 through 10.
Consider some tough situations you might be facing. Try practicing a new habit of saying, "I trust you, Jesus," in each circumstance. Say a prayer of thanks that you can trust God no matter what.
January 5th. You can achieve the victorious life through living in deep dependence on me. People usually associate victory with success, not falling or stumbling, not making mistakes. But those who are successful in their own strength tend to go their own way, forgetting about me. It is through problems and failure, weakness and neediness, that you learn to rely on me. True dependence is not simply asking me to bless what you have decided to do. It is coming to me with an open mind and heart, inviting me to plant my desires within you. I may infuse within you a dream that seems far beyond your reach. You know that in yourself you cannot achieve such a goal. Thus begins your journey of profound reliance on me. It is a faith walk, taken one step at a time, leaning on me as much as you need. This is not a path of continual success, but of multiple failures. However, each failure is followed by a growth spurt, nourished by increased reliance on me. Enjoy the blessedness of a victorious life through deepening your dependence on me.
Contemplate the following words from Scripture about depending on God.
The righteous cry out, and the Lord hears them. He delivers them from all their troubles. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. Psalm 34, verses 17 through 18. For we walk by faith, not by sight. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7.
Think about what you are trying to do on your own that you could turn over to God. Allow yourself to release your view of success and open your heart to what God has for you.
January 6th. I am able to do far beyond all that you ask or imagine. Come to me with positive expectations, knowing that there is no limit to what I can accomplish. Ask my spirit to control your mind so that you can think great thoughts of me. Do not be discouraged by the fact that many of your prayers are yet unanswered. Time is a trainer, teaching you to wait upon me, to trust me in the dark. The more extreme your circumstances, the more likely you are to see my power and glory at work in the situation. Instead of letting difficulties draw you into worrying, try to view them as setting the scene for my glorious intervention. Keep your eyes and your mind wide open to all that I am doing in your life.
Reflect on these words from Scripture about God's glory.
Now to Him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to His power that is at work within us, to Him be glory in the Church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. Ephesians chapter 3, verses 20 through 21. The mind of sinful man is death, but the mind controlled by the Spirit is life and peace. Romans chapter 8, verse 6. Even the youths shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Isaiah chapter 40, verses 30 through 31. Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth, and under the earth and on the sea, and all that is in them singing, To Him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb be praise and honor and glory and power forever and ever. Revelation chapter 5, verse 13.
Think of something you've been praying over that God doesn't seem to have answered yet. Ask Him to give you peace over this circumstance and remind you that His power and glory are at work in every situation.
January 7th. It is impossible to praise or thank me too much. As it is written, I inhabit the praises of my people. Sometimes your adoration is a spontaneous overflow of joy in response to radiant beauty or rich blessings. At other times, your praise is more disciplined and measured, an act of your will. I dwell equally in both types of praise. Thankfulness also is a royal road to draw near me. A thankful heart has plenty of room for me. When you thank me for the many pleasures I provide, You affirm that I am God, from whom all blessings flow. When adversity strikes and you thank me anyway, your trust in my sovereignty is a showpiece in invisible realms. Fill up the spare moments of your life with praise and thanks.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.